Kia ora, everyone. You might recognise I'm sitting in the kitchen here at Premier House in Wellington, having just come back from the hospital where I was with the Health Minister, David Clark, making a really significant announcement around cancer care in New Zealand. Many of you who have tracked investment in by the government, investment by us into health, will know that in the last budget we've made significant undertakings to try and turn around what's been what we consider to be really significant underinvestment in healthcare over a number of years, with, for instance, $2.8 billion into operational funding for health, but also $1.7 billion for capital into health. Now, the reason that was important today for the announcement that we made was that's what's allowing us to make big investments into the quite costly equipment required for cancer care in New Zealand. And here's the example we were specifically talking about: linear accelerators. They're the machines that unfortunately many will be familiar with that deliver radiation therapy to a large number of New Zealanders who might have lung cancer, breast cancer, common forms of cancer. Those pieces of equipment, those linear accelerators, are predominantly available in our city centres. But actually, of those thousands of New Zealanders who are diagnosed with cancer, roughly one in two of those individuals would benefit from accessing radiation therapy. But actually, only one in three will actually choose to access radiation therapy. And a big reason for that, if you speak to doctors in hospitals, they'll tell you, is because of the distance people have to travel to access what will sometimes be a daily course of treatment over maybe several weeks, 6 weeks in some cases. So for instance, we know across areas like Taranaki, Northland, the Hawke's Bay, people are having to travel several hours daily in order to access that care. Now, I know a lot of people will know stories of people who either choose not to then take up that care, they might opt instead to have more invasive surgery, or just opt not to have that treatment at all, even though it will deliver better outcomes for them because of those accessibility issues. No one should have to make that choice. So what we've announced today is that out of that capital investment that we made last budget, we will be purchasing 12 linear accelerators, and that those will be going into those regions I've mentioned: Hawke's Bay, Taranaki, Northland. And roughly, we know there are currently roughly 1,000 people who are currently having to travel a significant way that would not, once these are in place, have to travel that far. Now, in the past, DHBs have had to buy those machines themselves, and that's a significant outlay, and is meaning that some DHBs have delayed those purchases. Linear accelerators are meant to last about 10 years, but some of the ones we have currently operating in New Zealand, it's more like 16. So it's a necessary investment, a really important one, and it will mean those people who need to access that care will be able to access it more readily. This is only one part, of course, of a much wider plan that's needed to improve cancer care in New Zealand. Where at the moment the Minister of Health is working on an interim cancer action plan. He's already indicated that in several weeks' time, roughly, that will be available as well. But we wanted to get on with this investment because it is going to take a bit of time to build the bunkers that they need to go into, and so quite a bit of work needs to be done to get some of the hospitals ready to have this investment, so, and these machines available. So it's just one part of what we need to do to make sure that people get consistent care across the country, but a really important part. Look, I'm just reading, obviously, a lot of comment also on the page around Ihimato, and want to acknowledge, obviously, people have seen last Friday that as government, despite this being an issue where obviously all parties are currently in dialogue, we see a role for us to play in helping to broker a solution, which I think is what all parties want there. And so on Friday, we met with representatives of Mana Whenua, and at that time it was made clear there'd be no construction on the site while a solution was being sought. And so I've been staying in touch in particular with Labor's ministers who have been very active on the ground, supporting some of those talks that have been taking place, supporting finding a resolution. And so I've been in touch with them over the past few days, over the past week, as all parties continue in that dialogue. And that's the role, really, I think that we should be playing, is supporting a solution to be found. And I know those talks are live and active, and we'll keep trying to play that role to help broker that solution. Look, that's something then I've just been asked questions here about on the ground. Shania, can't answer that. Those are operational decisions, but I've spoke to some who've been around the site, but certainly I'll see whether or not what they've seen on the ground there today. Excuse me while I read as you type, everyone. Happy to always try and answer questions as we go, but sometimes my multitasking of reading and answering is... Carrie, not at all. Absolutely staying in touch with what's happening there on the ground. Of course, making sure that we're continuing to invest in healthcare doesn't also change the fact that we do see that we have a role to play in trying to help support resolution to be found with Ihimato as well. Certainly when you're in government, you're constantly having to play a role in multiple things at one time. So that's what we're trying to do. Again, multitasking. Certainly, Emma, certainly not ignoring what's going on there. You'll see that I met with Mana Whenua on Friday, tried to support that dialogue on Ihimato to continue. Really what we're trying to do is make sure that we allow that to happen, support solutions being found amongst those who are directly involved. Our Māori ministers have been on site and very proactive in trying to help support a resolution to be found, particularly Pini Henare, Willie Jackson, Nanaia Mahuta as well. So certainly staying really engaged there as well. Daniel, look, one of the things we've been clear about right from the beginning, the decisions around the operational side, the police, that is very much for the police. We don't dictate the decisions they make, and nor should we. I don't think anyone would expect the government to give writing instructions to the police. Those are ultimately matters for them. Okay, everyone, thanks for joining me for a little bit of discussion around linear accelerators. You may have hopefully got a bit more detail than you might have otherwise from some of the descriptions that you've seen in the quick headlines around what we've invested in today. But I'm sure we'll have more to say on cancer treatment, cancer care in New Zealand over the coming weeks, particularly as we work towards that action plan, which will be released shortly. And I hope everyone's once again enjoyed the backdrop that is the floral motif of the Premier House curtains in the kitchen. All right, thanks for joining us, everyone. I hope you have all a wonderful week, and I'll tune in again soon. Take care.